וכולם מקבלים עליהם ומלכות שמיים. וכולם מקבלים עליהם ומלכות שמיים. וכולם מקבלים, מקבלים עליהם ומלכות שמיים. ומלכות שמיים.
Shalom ve'yom tov. Hi and good day. Zman le'ivrit. It's time for Hebrew. The name of our Torah portion this week is Korach. Korach is the name of a man, but it also means in Hebrew, bald. Let's begin our lesson by reading Numbers 16, verse 1, the first verse in Torah portion Korach. Vayikach Korach ben Yitzhar. Ben Kehat, Ben Levi, Vedatan, Veaviram, Bnei Eliav, Veon, Ben Pelet, Bnei Ruvain, Vayakumu, Lifnei Moshe. Let's take a look at the names that we have in our Torah portion. Of course, we have Korach, and he was Ben Yitzhar, the son of Yitzhar, son of Kehat, son of Levi. Also in this week's Torah portion, we read about Datan and Aviram. They were the sons of Eliav. Finally, we read of On. He was the son of Pelet. All of them were sons of Reuven, Bnei Reuven. They rose up Lifnei Moshe. Let's look now at our challenge teachings, beginning with challenge teaching number 1. How do we say son in Hebrew? That's correct. It is Ben. How many times in this verse do we find the word? Well, we find it once in the second line, twice in the third line, and one more time in the sixth line, Ben Pelet. How about, how do you say the sons of? Remember, we've learned that when you add a yud to a Hebrew word, it takes on a form of possession. Therefore, if you want to say the son of, you'll say Bnei. We're very familiar with this as we've read about Bnei Yisrael through the whole of Torah. How many times is Bnei found in the opening verse of this Torah portion? Only twice, in the fifth line and the seventh line. Once to say Bnei Eliav and once to say Bnei Reuven. If we take a look at the Hebrew name Eliav, we find something very interesting. Remember the Hebrew word El means God? Well, here we find the Hebrew word El followed by a Yud, which means God of. And what's the last part of the name? Av. Do you remember what Av means? That's right, Father. The Hebrew name Eliav means God of my father. It's a nice name even to this day in Israel. And for short, many call their sons Eli. Let's take a moment and look for some roots. Challenge teaching number 3 says, we know from the Torah service that when the ark traveled, Moshe would say, Kuma Adonai. What does this mean? It means arise Adonai. The root for arise or get up is kum. In this Torah portion, we have a related form. It's found in the second line from the bottom. The word is vaya kumu, and it means, and they rose up. And last, challenge teaching number 4, who was it that kum lifnei Moshe, rose up against Moses? This is your chance to practice all the new names that you've learned in this week's verse. First, you can write Korach, and then Datan, and Aviram, and last, On. Remember, when you write the name On, you're going to remove the vav from the beginning of the name. The vav was only there to denote the word and. The same is true when you write Datan and Aviram. Let's look now to the left-hand side of the page and see if we can find Numbers 16, verse 1 in our Torah scroll. It might take us a few minutes since we have so many paragraph breaks. We will find our verse after the last paragraph break toward the bottom of the page. Let's read from our Torah scroll on the left-hand side. If you can't read without the vowel markings, then follow along with your finger. Let's begin. Vayikach Korach ben Yitzchar בן קהת, בן לוי, ודתן ואבירם, בני אליאב, ואון, בן פלט, בני רובן, ויקומו לפני משה. Certainly this has not been a good Torah portion to be the star of, but we learn many lessons from this week's Torah portion, Parshat Korach. Talmidim, enjoy your studies this week, both in the Torah and Be'ivrit, in Hebrew. Shavua Tov, Litraot.